Hi guys, Kirk and Jason here with Kirk Giordano Plastering. Today, I want to show you guys some things because I get asked a couple questions. One of them is, how much water do you have to put on a base coat prior to applying a color coat? And I thought, good question. And another question I get asked not too often is, somebody will call me and they'll say, hey Kirk, I watched your video and we did our scratch coat and we forgot to put lines in it. Do we need to tear it all off? And I'll say, no, you don't need to tear it all off. What you need to do is either put a bonding agent on it or hydrate it well. For the sake of answering how to hydrate a wall, and hydrate, that means wet it down, mist it, water it, hose it, whatever you want to call it, guys. Okay, notice how that's darkening. It's darkening because this is a cementitious finish, and just like a brick, which is also cementitious, it will darken when wet. That's the beauty of a brick. It lasts forever. The color fades in a matter of 80 years, but it lasts forever. Stucco is the same thing. Now, if you watch this, in some areas, it's an inch thick. We did this base coat about a month ago. So this is an inch thick. Now, what's going to happen is the water is going to absorb into this wall quickly in some areas. If we were in this too, guys, if you're in the hot sun, say you're doing a whole house, a color coat, you want to hose the whole house down, what I'll do is I'll generally look for an area I'm going to start with the color. And that's what I'll hose down first and then hose the rest of it down. And the sun plays a factor too, but for the sake of this, I won't get into that. Now, it hasn't been long, but what you'll see is it starts to dry out. The top is starting to dry out. The corner is starting to dry out a little bit. Now, if I were to just take a color coat and start putting it on here, it's not really ready for a color coat at this stage. I just hit it. What I want to do is I want to give it about 10 minutes or 15. Here's what I'm going to do too, guys. I already know this is going to start drying out. What I want is I want the scratch coat and the brown coat to be moist. And I want it where we apply the color, that inch thick takes about 8 hours to dry out. If I apply a color coat right now, it'll dry out in about an hour because only the top is wet. So what I'm going to do, guys, is I'm going to continue hitting this. And this is what you guys would do if you're planning to do a color coat. You see how it's starting to seep down here, guys? That just means that water, this is new, fresh, and it's sucking in right here. This is one of the most important things you can do when doing a color coat. You have to know how to hydrate the wall properly. And what I do is I just keep going here, keep going. What I want to do is spend 5 minutes. No, I'm not going to put this for five more minutes while you guys watch, but you get an idea. And we're going to start other things. And I'm going to come back to this wall. And when I do, you'll see it's kind of dried out a little bit. And I'm going to hit it one more time. I'm going to miss it then. I'm going to go like this. And that way our color coat will adhere. It'll adhere by suction. Why is that so important, guys? Well, say, take a color coat and you put it over a dry wall. Now that color coat over a dry wall won't get a good bond. So as fast as you put a color coat on a dry wall, it'll suck up to it, and that texture and base coat will be loose. It will come off eventually. So you've got to know how to do these things right for the longevity of a color coat. So I'll come back to this and I'll show you a little bit more. All right, guys, it's only been about 15 minutes, but the sun is starting to shine here, so we're going to lose the ability to show this accurately. Notice all of this right here is pretty dry. The water and both the base, the scratch and the brown are starting to come down. That's what the weep screed is for. It weeps out. So I can see this is still wet down below, so that's fine. What I'll do now is we're ready to go. We actually started on another wall, but we're going to come here. Again, the same thing applies. I want to put the wall water on here, and I want it to be able to drip down. I want to saturate this wall. I want it to slowly dry. Why? Because I want a good suction for this cementitious color coat finish we're doing. And by the way, over there, you see, Lou, he's got the color coat coming. That color coat comes usually in three textures. This is a heavy texture. It comes in fine, medium, and coarse. So for an example, okay, if I was to put this on right now, what happens? Okay, I'm putting it on a surface that's too wet, but it just shows my time in because I made it work. Normally, if it's too wet, guys, it just starts falling down, but I'm used to this stuff. Anyway, the water right here, you see it's starting to drip through here, and it will bleach out the color. Right now, there's no color in this. It's just pigment because they're painting, but you see all that water, it's coming right here. And if there was a color in here, any of the colors, except for crystal white, it will bleach the crap out of that color. So the idea now is to wait until all the water has come down. And that does take practice, guys. I mean, it takes sometimes 20 years to, you know, 30 homes to learn how to do this properly. So if you make a mistake, it takes old Kirk a long time to do that too. So anyway, I'm gonna scrape this back off because I'm trying to give you guys an idea of when to put that color coat on. In another 15 minutes, this wall will be ready. How about I just say that? And lastly, guys, I'll point out something over here where if this wall was painted, now what you would need a bonding agent. A lot of you guys say, I can't find Weldcrete anywhere. It's made by Larson's. Guys, you don't need to use Weldcrete. I use Weldcrete because it's blue, and I can see if we missed an area. Quickcrete, they make a good bonding agent. Sikka makes a good bonding agent, but that's only for a house that's painted. You have to pressure wash first very well because nothing here is a dust. Then you use these bonding agents. But this is cementitious finish. We're putting it over a base coat. We do not need a bonding agent. It adheres through suction, and that's what this whole video is about. How to apply enough water to create the suction we want. Anyway, I hope I didn't confuse you guys too much, but there's no simple answer to hydrating these walls prior to the color coat. My name is Kirk, Jason on the camera. We thank you for watching, and as usual, we'll see you guys on the next one. Once again, folks, we thank you for watching, and I really enjoy all your comments.
If you guys like this video, please click the like button down below, and also, if you enjoy what we do, subscribe to our channel so we can keep making these videos for you.
My name is Kirk.
And Jay.
We thank you for watching, and from the entire Giordano family, we'll see you on the next one.